Hello, everybody! This is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome back to the Mario Kart Double Dash playthrough. In our last episode, we took on the Star Cup, and now in this episode, we are moving on to our next cup, the Special Cup. And going by my format of alternating between 150cc and Mirror, in this episode, we will be doing the Special Cup on Mirror Mode. So let's go ahead and get our character combination, and I'm sticking with my champs. Toad and Paratroopa, these guys haven't lost yet. Let's keep that winning streak going with the Special Cup. Now, normally in most Mario Kart games, the Special Cup is your final test, and it's gonna give us a pretty decent challenge, especially on Mirror Mode, so let's go ahead and get started. We are starting off with one of my favorite courses in the game, Wario Coliseum. That's right, he doesn't have a little pussy stadium anymore. Now he's got a Coliseum. He's like the Romans. Where are the lions? I don't see no lions, Wario. He's even got it looking like the Roman Coliseum, which I have actually seen in real life. Seriously, take my advice, ladies and gentlemen. If you ever get a chance, take a trip to Rome. Even if it's just in college as part of a class. Seriously, you will not regret it. Because Rome is an awesome city. And speaking of awesome things, we're playing an awesome game of Mario Kart Double Dash going through this crazy course. I mean, it was definitely with the GameCube entry in this series that Mario Kart really started to go off with the crazy tracks. Because, I mean, you had a little bit of it in Mario Kart 64, but it was definitely Double Dash that turned things up. Why am I getting hit by everything? I have to have some urgency on this track because this track does not have the traditional three laps. It's so long, it actually has only two laps, so I have to make a move here and try to pass Wario and Luigi if this game is gonna let me do anything. God, I feel like I'm being punished. Well, I got the triple mushroom and I got Toad's special item, the golden mushroom. Go, go, go! Use it to its fullest potential! Hey, Wario! Guess who's back? Oh, and it's baby Luigi. Okay, never mind. I thought I saw a green hat, but I wasn't sure who. Again, some of these combinations, I talked about it when I was playing Mushroom Cup 150cc. It's kind of weird. On 150cc and Mirror Mode, they don't go with the logical character combinations. Oh, and I just dodged your red shell, boy! How do you like that? Come on, let's keep this going. We can't let up here. Take this shortcut. I always take this jump. Always take this jump when you can. It's definitely quicker than going around the big opening, but we should be up. Screw it, just go. Just go. Go. Sorry, Toad, I know I'm gonna give you some serious road burns or whatever, but we gotta win this race, buddy. We're just dragging Toad by the face. Man, that had to be uncomfortable. But despite some adversity, including two blue shells, we are able to conquer Wario Coliseum, and we actually win pretty comfortably. Look at the time difference between first and second. Was able to get a pretty good lead at the very end, and victory's ours. So the first course of the Special Cup is down and out. It's on to the next course, which is Jurassic Park. Dino Jungle, which is a pretty interesting track. I mean, it's got friggin' dinosaurs, for God's sake. Dinosaurs are awesome, right? Even though they're extinct. This one has its own fair share of obstacles that we're going to have to cope with and hopefully overcome, which we will do because we are Toad and Paratroopa, the best combination in the game, in my opinion. like I said, I like this combination based pretty much, maybe not exclusively, but a big part of the reason why I like this combination is the combination of the special items. I really do think that Golden Mushroom and Triple Shell is the best combination in the game. People are free to dispute that, and you can say that another combination is your favorite, but that's just me. This combination works for me. I've rarely lost, even on the highest difficulty settings, with this combination. Again, since I'm playing a lightweight, I do have to watch out when I try to go against heavyweight carts, because I will get pushed around, and I don't have the highest top speed, but I don't know, this combination, I've talked about it before, it just works. Also, I almost drove right off the damn level. Let's not do that. So plenty of hazards here. You got the giant dinosaur right here that you encounter twice in the level. He can push you off that bridge, so don't touch him. And there's also early on where he's stomping around. You want to avoid his feet when that happens. Also, and something else I've always found kind of funny about mirror mode. Even Lakitu is mirrored. Like, even his sign was backwards. I just find that funny how literally everything is flipped around in mirror mode. And once again, Toad is going for the ride of his life. Man, Toad's getting punished out here. Let's keep going. We got a good lead on him, but that could change any moment. This is mirror mode. On the higher difficulty levels, this game will screw you over, or it'll at least make the best effort to do so. But no such shenanigans are going to take place here, as we win very comfortably. This game's getting soft on me. I thought mirror mode was supposed to be hard. This is a joke, right? I just know my cockiness is gonna come back to bite me. But I have to gloat. Anyway, Dino Dino Jungle is out of the way. We've got 20 points, halfway done. On to the next course, and this course is a very familiar sight. It's time for Bowser's Castle, a Mario Kart tradition. It's not a Mario Kart game if Bowser doesn't build his own course for it, and this one is definitely a step up from the classic course that was in Mario Kart 64. Definitely a step up thanks to the superior hardware of the Nintendo GameCube. But we're going to be dealing with thwomps, much like we dealt with in Mario Kart 64. We're going to be dealing with the lava that you can fall into, so watch yourself. We're going to be dealing with fireballs and all this other crazy stuff en route to ultimate victory. And we're doing it mirrored, no less, for a little extra challenge. Although, really, mirror mode isn't really that bad. You just gotta just be careful because, you know, you can be really used to, going through normally, and then all of a sudden, you, flip it around, and that can throw you off the first time around. But anyway, how's that for an impressive feature? A giant mechanical Bowser statue that shoots fireballs. You really want to watch it when dealing with that thing, because that part of the course basically becomes a giant shooting gallery. And, you're the target. Put it mildly. Also, what's with the lightning bolt? Did I piss off Zeus? See you back there, Mario and King. Mario and King Boo working together. What kind of combo is that? Mario, you do know that he trapped you in a painting, right? And your brother had to save your ass? Why are you partners with him? I guess Mario's a very forgiving fellow. Starman! Why, thank you, whoever dropped that. Finders keepers. Hey, it actually helped me, because I ran into that item box, which was my own. That's one of the most embarrassing things that can happen to you in a Mario Kart game. You're just driving along, you set an item, and then later on you accidentally run into it for whatever reason. I've had that happen. But it's really embarrassing when you launch a green shell and then all of a sudden it bounces off the damn wall and it hits you. I've had that happen many times. And it's just, it makes me slap my forehead because it's like it's, it, you'd think it would be avoidable, but it actually happens pretty easily. Okay, I really want to do this friggin' shortcut off this jump, so let me do it, game. And I come off at a bad angle. So yeah, there is a little shortcut right there, but you want to be careful when you try to do it because of the fireballs from the Bowser statue. I had it, except I went at it at a bad angle. That's embarrassing. Alright, we got this, boys. Yeah. Okay, I think we have this pretty well in hand. 30 points, 3 straight victories. And we've got one more track left to go, and if you know your Mario Kart, you should know what track is coming up at this point. It is time for Rainbow Road, and this one looks quite impressive, even nowadays. And it's our final test before conquering the Special Cup. Let's do this! Why not on the most epic track of them all? Rainbow Road is pretty much always the final track in every Mario Kart game, and the best way to look at it is it's basically a grand finale of everything you've done up to this point in this game. So, Rainbow Road tends to be pretty epic, and also very difficult unless you're playing Mario Kart 64. As much as I love Mario Kart 64 and I love the music track for that game's version of Rainbow Road, the course itself in Mario Kart 64 is a friggin' joke. Oh, come on! Not this again! Really? The combo again? But at least it happened on the first lap. I said it before. I can handle it on the first lap. Yeah, suckers! How's it feel? Tell me how it feels. Wow, whoever threw that, thank you very much for helping me out. I'll give you a cut of my winner's money or something. Even though we're not playing for money, I wish. I am on a YouTube partnership, but I'm not exactly rich because of it. Not that I expected it, but, you know, make a little money on the side. Although in real life, I would like to get back to a legitimate job search. God's sake! Blue shells! This game's getting as bad as Mario Kart Wii! No, don't you dare! Ah, I knew that would happen! Wow, how am I gonna recover from this? Start me off by getting a mushroom, really. I mean, that's gonna give me a boost. But man, I'm getting my ass kicked. It's only the second lap, though. We can recover. We will recover. Oh my god, why? I was building momentum and then they hit me with a friggin' lightning bolt. This isn't funny, game. And how did I not touch that item box? Yeah, you hit that damn fake item box, which I personally dropped. And then I think I hit my own later down the track. Oh, I should have saved that mush. I should have saved that banana. I'm saving this. Oh, wow, really? He almost shunted me right off again. Just gotta, okay. We need to time this right. Get hit, get hit. Oh, they had a green shell to block it. You dirty tricksters. Yeah! Take that, suckers. You better fall off, you jerks. Payback. They knocked me off earlier. I'm gonna get that payback, baby. Don't mess with me. Don't mess with the mat. Because the mat will punish you. And I can be pretty vengeful, baby. And now we're gonna win. And it played that glitch again where Toad talked twice. Come on, man. You're not the only one here. You know, you got a partner, right? Let him celebrate. Sheesh, Toad. Hogging the spotlight. And we're hogging the victory right here, baby. Special Cup has been beaten. Although we're not looking like winners right now because we just fell off again. Like it matters. So the Special Cup, a clean sweep. And that's four cups down, ladies and gentlemen. Normally, that would be the end of this playthrough, but we're not quite done yet. However, we're not going to worry about it right now. Let's just sit back and enjoy the award ceremony. There it is, ladies and gentlemen, that is the Special Cup. However, we have one more challenge left to do, which we will showcase in the next episode. That is a wrap on this episode of the Mario Kart Double Dash playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw in this video, please don't forget to like and leave a comment. If you're new to the channel and you liked this video and you want to see more, be sure to subscribe, because I would really appreciate it. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next episode.